that's a very interesting machine. I mentioned before that Hugh Anderson rode one of the Tom Dermody ex-Greg Hansford bikes, and that looks very much like it. I'm sure it's not an original, but great to see it out there with the Kawasaki livery of Brian Ashdown from Hamilton. Good-looking bike. One of the classics out there here at Hampton Downs. Last race of the day, so let's make it a good one. Last time it was a beauty. It was Daniel Metham versus Dennis Charlotte. I just wonder if Daniel might still have the aggression pills right to the fore after being pipped by Robbie Bugden in the Superbike TT. We'll wait and see. We'll let this one unfold for a little while. They're working their way through swampy curves for four laps. This race scheduled to go over. Then they head through to Kev's Carousel, and it's on to the Double B. This interesting corner that certainly has piqued the interest of a lot of the competitors here today at Hampton Downs. The race leader, as they left the line, it was, I think anyway, Dennis Charlotte. We'll see if he's in the front now, or will it be Dan Metham? Over the top and heading down into the dipper they go. And out on the short chute. Good little scrap going on for the miners by the look of it. Patrick Nussbaum is right up there from Kirikiri. The dreadlock Kawasaki rider, but he isn't in front of a very tall rider. Let's see what happens as they come down to complete their first one. And it is by the look of it, Dina Charlotte leading it from Racing and all the classic register racing as well on that big Suzuki, that 1000cc Suzuki. Neil Martin followed him, and then it was Scott Finlay and Graham Murray. Graham Murray, the rugby player. But no, not at all. Although I think I heard a rumour. I was talking to a friend of mine at Sky, and I think Josh Cronfeld might be a bit of a motorcycle fan. He'd like to have a go at road racing. I know they did a little piece on bikes here, I think at Hampton Downs a couple of months ago, I should say, and he was very keen.
Do you remember?
To have a go.
Do you know David Letter?
Yes.
Did you follow
absolutely.
David in motocross?
Well, no, because he's an Otago man. Yes.
Yeah, yeah. a keen motocrosser and a very good motocrosser, and his son Madison, now running an MX2 in New Zealand. He's been the junior 250 Supercross champion from the title being contested at Winton, and a very
that
competent.
Be hard. There's only about four riders in that.
There was a handful more, but you can, hey, it was unless you, for anybody that wanted to be in Supercross,
yes,
was all there.
So,
yeah,
yes.
Yep.
It's all about design.
So David himself still riding a bit of Vince motocross as well. A very, very world-class rugby player. Could have gone overseas and could have done a lot of things. And probably mean actually ahead of his time. He's been around professionally a long time. Cloud Tago captain as well. So
hard man, they won the
toughest team.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Suzuki, so finding this fabulous, and he was loving every bit of it. So you've got Dennis and Daniel. No, they don't own the bikes that they're riding, but I tell you what, own them like you've stolen it. Is that the statement to make?
Because, ride it like you stole it.
Yeah, ride it like you stole it, exactly. And ride it like you've stolen it. Well, I'm certainly riding them to be championship contenders because, you know, racing's in your blood. You're not going to just say, oh, I'm going easy. Well, what's the definition of easy? Now, you may not go 11 tenths, but you're still going to have a go at 10 tenths for sure because you don't want to let anybody else take that advantage. Dennis Charlotte, Daniel Metham, Matt Eagleton ahead of Phil Duxbury, David, my apologies, Scott of Finlay from Neil Martin and Graham Moorhead, Patrick Nussbaum, there with Dan Jenkins, and of course, two-stroke there with Mark Robinson in the first of those. And remembering the number eight of Mr. Sir Mike Perro back there in the 17th place. Remembering he's in the two-stroke field, that split group at the end of the field. So he's putting in a very good effort when you take that consideration that he'd let the others get away in front of him. And Alan Dillon to it. Castro, 6 hour winner. A hero of racing in New Zealand. The Honda days back in the 80s. And there he is still doing it in his love of motorcycling.
So we're on the last lap of the last race of what has been a fantastic weekend. I just wonder if Dan Menon's got something for Dennis. We came off the weekend with Dennis chasing around the three races we've shown you of the two-stroke Grand Prix bikes and the classics. I just wonder if he can do it here, if he can just squeeze out a win. Be quite fitting. I don't think it's going to happen, but you never know. You just never know. Not too much of this one still to come, and here they come, and they're side by side. They're going to make a race of it now, Richie. Look at this. He just got the nose in front. That was very, very close indeed. So my predictions for the first time, I think, in the whole weekend are going to come true because
No,
white flag is out. The checkered flag is going to be waved very shortly, and it's going to be for Daniel No, that's not. That's Phil Duxbury. There he is. No, that's not him.
No, it was that way. It was 34 and 20. In the end, there was quite a gap between him.
Yes,
it was over 2 seconds in the end, but they did go past the 34. Down there. Man, speaking about a close call, I've had the privilege of looking at a slow-mo of Jamie Maynard's crash here, turning number one yesterday. And if you get an opportunity for him, have a look at it. These people have got it on edited coverage. Shows Jamie in losing it on the inside and his two other riders on the outside, and as he skids across the track and his bike's going across the track, and how these other two bikes intersect and they miss each other like a scissor movement, and you look at it all in slow motion. It's milliseconds, and it's just all happening, of course, at the flick of the switch. Jamie Maynard, who may not have started the last superbike race, but he'd blown his oil filter on Friday.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and then his crash out yesterday. So, man, that guy should buy a lot of tickets because he may have started the race today. He should get some of the two crashes in 2 days and bring it back because.